Okay, good morning everyone. Please give me more spirit. Good morning everyone.
Good morning.
Okay, those who are at home, good morning students.
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. How are you? Fine, thank you.
I'm fine.
I'm fine also. Thank you for not asking, okay? Let's do it once again. Remember, when someone greets you, please give response, okay? And don't forget also to ask, how are you? It's just like for a normal courtesy, okay? This is normal courtesy. Let's do it once again, okay? I don't give up easily, okay? Good morning, students!
Good morning!
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
I'm fine, thanks. I hope everyone is in a good condition, okay? Right now, I will take the attendance for the students who are in the classroom, okay? Whenever I call your name and you are here, say present, okay? Muhammad Arfian Sandi. Present. Okay, let's do it once again. Muhammad Arfian Sandi. Present. Oh, soft voice, yeah, okay. Very soft. Okay, next. Yemima Mikael Epaphroditus. Okay, here or present, it's okay, yeah. Shalom. Present, shalom, this is shalom, yeah. Marcel. Marcel, present. This is my first time looking at your face, yeah. Ratu. Ya, Ratu ini beberapa kali ketemu kelihatannya ya. Imam. Nabila. Okay, present Nabila. Kanastren. Okay, Kanastren, the one with beautiful voice, ya. Yeah. Rafid. Okay, Rafid. Naku. Alright. Natania. Yes, okay. Kalia. Okay, Kalia. This is Kalia. Muhammad Dana Diaksa or Aksa, ya. Aksa, let me see your face. Okay. Pasha. Oh, hi Pasha. Okay. Thank you. So, 13 students. 13. Wait. And those who are from home? Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 5, 6. Here, Aksa ya. Aksa juga ikut di ini, nggak apa-apa. Jesse, okay. Alright, so now we have 7 friends at home. Class 13 equals with 20. And we are actually 32 students, right? 32 students minus 20, yeah. Equals with 12. 12 students are missing. Oh, now we have Oscar. We have Naku. Okay. That's not supposed to be for you yet. Oh yeah, Mas. Yeah. Put on your facial, please. Now I am admitting your friends. They are entering. They are late, yeah. Okay, hi Oscar, welcome. All right. Now, since we have 13 here and then 13 here, equals with 26 students, now we are ready, I guess, okay? Now, because now we are ready, I need you to remember to put on your face shield always. This is your shield from me, okay? And from your friends. When I do this, just to make me clearer, looking at the screen, it's, I'm opening my shield. So I open myself from the fire. Okay, well, I hope everything is okay for us, yeah? Now, before we start, do you have anything to share or to say? or to inform before we start? No? Now, do you still remember what we discussed last meeting? We learned about recount text. Do you still remember what recount text is? It's a text to tell about stories, past event, yeah? Things that happened in the past. And what is the generic structure for recount text? Do you remember? Orientation, events, and then reorientation. That's on the slide, ada di slide loh, yang pertemuan kemarin-kemarin itu. Masya ya, ikut ya. Jadi, Shalom juga, ya kan? Itu kan yang Zoom ketika kalian at home and your friends are here, ya. What is the pattern for apa pola kalimat dari recount text? Mainly, utamanya. Simple past tense. What is the pattern for simple past tense? Polanya apa? Simple past tense. Subject plus verb. Verb?
Verb 2.
Verb 2, yes. Thank you. Ada yang jawab ini di sana ya. Yeah, you are right. Subject plus verb 2. Diingat ya, itu recount text. Ini mesti sebagian besar nggak membaca ini ya. Okay, now we move on. Yeah. Oh yeah, wait. The function for recount text. Fungsinya recount text apa? Anyone from home? Yang di rumah? Anyone? Let's have Alin.
Buat ceritain kejadian masa lalu, Mem.
Ya, untuk menceritakan kejadian yang sudah terjadi di masa lalu, ya. This morning, last year, last holiday, seperti itu. Thank you, Alin. Ya, okay. Now we will talk or discuss something different, not recount text. Okay. I hope recount text is on our test next. Text, okay? Besok untuk kenaikan kelas, recount text masuk ya. Sudah saya share kemarin batasan materi. Now, wait. Right now, we are going to learn something different. Let me check. Naku. Loh, di sini dong. Oh, sorry. Della Anggi. Dia sudah online and she left the screen ya. Cantika?
Ya.
Yeah. Yeah, can you see the screen? Bisa lihat screen ya?
Iya.
Yeah, okay. This is for checking. Now right now, I need you to help me to read this. We are going to learn about notice, caution and warning, okay? Simple material, okay? Notice, caution, and warning. Now, let's have Cantika. Where are you? Please read the slide.
Okay. Indikator menentukan gambaran umum atau pikiran utama paragraf, tersurat atau tersirat, atau rujukan kata atau makna kata dalam teks fungsional pendek berbentuk notice, caution, atau warning.
Yes, thank you, Cantika. Gambaran umum. So, by the end of this lesson, you are supposed to be able to understand caution, notice, and warning. To recognize whenever you see around us, and eventually, akhirnya, you are supposed to be able to make your own notice, warning, and caution. Okay? Jadi di akhir pelajaran ini diharapkan kalian mengenali notice yang ada di sekitar kita dan akhirnya bisa membuat notice-nya sendiri. Gitu ya. Oke. Next. Someone here in the classroom, can you see the slide?
No,
it's not here. silau. Maybe you can sit on the screen, on your, you join the Zoom, but it's not that the point, yeah? It's not clear. Yeah. Maybe you need to,
soalnya saya ini PDF.
Oke, saya akan baca ya. Or your friends at home. Let's have apero. Apero?
Mem, saya juga mau, Mem.
Oh, siapa ini?
Yes, Mem. Saya.
Siapa nih? Di raise your hand. Coba ya, akan dibacakan temanmu ya. Siapa nih yang langsung bisa on suaranya? Alin, Alin ya, please help.
Ya. Yang P ya, Mem.
Yes, ya, karena temanmu nggak bisa kelihatan ini.
A. Pengertian notice, caution, warning. Informasi singkat dan sederhana yang ditunjukkan untuk orang banyak. B. Bentuk notice, caution, warning. A. Kalimat perintah, comment, atau permintaan request. Seperti keep off the grass. B. Kalimat larangan, prohibition, contoh don't disturb. C, rambu-rambu, no smoking.
Oke, okay, thank you, Alin. Jadi, yang dibacakan tadi, ya. Yeah. So, this is the what notice is, oke okay, ya. Yeah. Notice atau caution atau warning itu adalah informasi singkat dan sederhana yang ditujukan untuk orang banyak. We have seen it a lot, ya. Yeah. Kita melihat ini banyak, especially at school. In the public places, di tempat-tempat umum, oke? Okay? And bentuknya itu adalah there are three, ya, ada tiga. Jadi ada gempa. There are three. The first one is comment atau kalimat perintah. For example, close the door. Stand up. Sit down. Berarti polanya apa? Pola kalimatnya. Itu kalimat deh, itu close the door, stand up, sit down, itu kalimat. Polanya apa? Kata kerja yang digunakan, kata kerja bentuk keberapa?
Pertama.
Pertama, betul, bentuk pertama ya. Jadi kayak sit, sit down tadi ya, sit, stand up, stand, sit, stand, close. Semuanya kata kerja bentuk pertama. Itulah komen. Kemudian ada request atau permintaan, biasanya lebih halus. Kalau lebih halus biasanya pakai apa? Pakai kata bantu apa? Ya, please. Ada kata please. Sit down, please. Close the door, please. Seperti itu. Itu juga bisa. And then the last, the second B. B, kalimat larangan atau prohibition. Ciri-cirinya adalah menggunakan apa?
Don't.
Don't. Ya, yeah, betul ya. Yeah. PPT-nya di-share. Oke, sebentar. Maaf ya yang di rumah, saya nge-share PPT dulu ke grup. Karena ini PowerPoint-nya enggak kelihatan. Nih. Betul, ada kata don't. Contoh-contohnya banyak sekali, ada don't apa? Don't disturb. Don't smoke. Bentar. PPT-nya kita share. Nah, ini. Dah. Oke. Don't. Jadi penggunaan don't kemudian diikuti dengan verb berapa? Verb
satu.
Verb satu juga. Jadi semuanya menggunakan verb bentuk pertama ya. Kayak disturb, smoke, close, open, itu semua bentuk pertama. Dan yang terakhir penggunaan rambu-rambu seperti no smoking. No smoking itu kalau dirubah jadi prohibition jadi apa? Ada yang tahu enggak?
Don't smoke.
Don't smoke, betul. Jadi sudah enggak pakai ing lagi tetapi langsung verb satunya smoking jadi smoke. Don't smoke. Oke, good. Lanjut. Next. Someone please help me. Let's have Gloria. Gloria Elvina. Gloria?
Iya. Yeah.
Please read. Help me to read this.
Okay. C. Makna notice, caution, atau warning. Notice, caution, atau warning umumnya membuat makna tentang hal atau tindakan yang harus atau tidak dibolehkan. D. Pertanyaan terkait notice, caution, warning. Maksud notice, caution, warning. Letak atau caution atau warning. Dan makna kata.
Thank you, Gloria.
Iya.
Yeah. Yeah. So notice, caution, atau warning is to tell us to do something or not to do something. Okay? To do something or not to do something. Itu yang maksudnya. Kemudian, biasanya soal-soal atau pertanyaan-pertanyaan mengenai materi ini, itu ada tiga. Yang pertama, makna katanya. Yang kedua, letaknya. Where does this caution probably take place? Biasanya pertanyaannya seperti itu. Where can you see this kind of notice? In the library, in the post office, in the classroom, begitu ya. Dan yang terakhir, what does this notice mean? Maksudnya, notice ini apa? Itu ya. Oke. Okay. Bentar. Kita akan langsung aja exercise. Silakan dilihat dulu exercise ini. Mau tetap enggak kelihatan ya? Kelihatan enggak the picture? Gambarnya. Gambarnya kelihatan? Oke, okay, kalau gambarnya kelihatan. Ada apa itu hand ya? Someone's hand and then holding something, and then we have the red cross, yeah. And then the writing, no littering. Do you know the meaning of littering? Kira-kira dari gambarnya ini kira-kira apa? Dalam bahasa Indonesia. Jangan buang sampah sembarangan, mungkin begitu ya kira-kira. Nah. This notice means A, throw your rubbish here. B, do not throw your rubbish here. C, bring your own rubbish. D, do not pick up the rubbish. A, B, C, or D?
A.
Yang di rumah? B.
A.
B.
B. Ah, yang di rumah ada yang menjawab A, ada yang menjawab B. Dan yang di in the classroom? B. Semua B. Are you sure? Yang A itu throw your rubbish here. Kalau seperti itu malah disuruh membuang sampah di situ atau
sampah semua.
Enggak boleh. Ada yang sengaja kelihatannya dia jawab A.
Tahu.
Ya. Apero tuh ya yang jawab A ya atau Adinda? tinggal antara mereka berdua ya. Jadi jawaban yang benar adalah B ya. B. So, do not, tidak boleh, do not. Do not throw your rubbish here. Rubbish itu adalah sampah.
Sampah.
Ada yang tahu nggak sinonimnya rubbish gitu? Sinonimnya? Sinonimnya kata rubbish apa? Apa?
Trash.
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 Good. Very good. Ada yang tahu ternyata. Next, let's move to this one. Someone please read. Ini karena yang di apa slide ini nggak terlalu jelas. Tapi mungkin udah ada yang bisa buka nih. Di ini coba saya minta tolong dibacain ya. Number two. Aha. Aha. Yes. So which one? A, B, C, D?
A.
A. A. Are you sure? Let's check someone from whom? Kelita. Kelita, you are very quiet.
B, ma'am.
Kelita, B. We are from.
Itu saya.
Hah?
Itu saya, ma'am. Kan Kelita.
Farid. let's have Oscar. Coba Oscar. Oscar, videonya dong semua dinyalakan videonya. Jadi saya bisa lihat kalau kamu ngerjain yang lain atau enggak. Ini Cantika ini yang di shoot apa ini? Nah, Adinda oke. Okay. Yang lainnya betul enggak mau menunjukkan wajahnya ya. Oke, okay, sebentar sebelum kita tentukan jawabannya. Do you find new words? Ada enggak kata yang baru atau yang difficult words dari soal maupun pilihan jawabannya? Ada?
Prohibited.
Apa?
Prohibited. Itu apa?
Prohibited. Prohibited dari kata prohibit. Apa?
Dilarang.
Dilarang. Jadi kalau prohibited itu dilarang. Oke, okay, good. Yang di rumah bisa menjawab itu kelihatannya ngerti ya. Permitted di
diizinkan.
Diizinkan. Diizinkan. Allow diperbolehkan. Sama ya? Oke.
Yeah.
Ya, jadi ini berarti jawaban yang benar adalah B. We are prohibited to enter the room? No.
No.
A.
No.
A.
Bentar,
Men.
Ya, coba.
A.
Sabar.
Masa kamu enggak bolehin masuk di kamar?
Sebentar, ya ampun.
We are not allowed to let the door open all the time, ya. Kita diizinkan untuk membiarkan pintu terbuka sepanjang waktu.
Waktu.
Biasanya ini adalah di mana?
Ruangan ber-AC, ma'am.
Di ruangan ber-AC. Air conditioned room, ya. Biasanya. Thank you. Next, number three. Coba yang di sini.
Apa ini? Oh.
Keep off the grass. Apa tuh grass?
Rumput, men.
Rumput, keep off. Itu berarti
Ya, dilarang
rumput. So, this notice means A, B, C.
C, men.
We must not walk on the grass, ya. Komplitnya begitu. We must not walk on the grass. Oke, okay, lanjut. Where does this probably take place? Biasanya ada di mana?
Di taman.
Taman, taman. In the garden, public garden ya biasanya. Di taman kota. Oke, okay, next. What is the activity in the picture?
Surfing.
Surfing, ya. Yeah. And then this notice means? Someone said see.
See.
You are not allowed to go surfing. Yes. Where does this probably take place? Biasanya ada di mana?
Pantai
on
laut.
The, on the beach. Oke. Okay. All right. Biasanya ada di pantai. Kalau swimming pool kira-kira ada nggak kayak gini? Enggak, gambarnya beda apa? Biasanya orang berenang gitu ya. Orang berenang dicoret di swimming pool. Kenapa? Karena lagi dikuras ya. Kalau nggak ada airnya, masa kamu berenang gitu maksudnya. Oke. Okay. Next, number five. This is the last one. Ini yang terakhir.
Tri Surani.
Do you find new words? Ada nggak kata baru di sini? Kata yang kamu nggak ngerti artinya? Apa?
Sesimi yang C.
Ya, chemicals. Chemicals itu apa? Bahan-bahan?
Kalau nggak salah.
Kimia. Bahan-bahan kimia. Storage?
Menyimpan.
Kan menyimpan? Nah, jadi this notice means yang di rumah A, B.